Hello everyone. My name is Louisa and I'm a higher degree research student from the Centre for Cancer Biology at the University of South Australia. On behalf of my co-authors, I am proud to present a summary of our recently published manuscript, IgG4-related disease, emerging roles of novel genetic variants, immune cell subsets, and therapeutic targets. IgG4-related disease, or IgG4-RD, is a rare and systemic inflammatory disorder. So, what's new in this field in 2025? Our review draws attention to IgG4-RD phenotypes in understudied cohorts, as well as recent findings in IgG4-RD-related microbiome research. We also discuss omics studies that have recently uncovered novel genetic variants linked to IgG4-RD. Specific germline mutations are emerging as key risk factors for disease development, providing clues to susceptibility and possible familial patterns. These discoveries may soon allow for earlier diagnosis and even the possibility of targeted personalized medicine. IgG4-RD is uniquely marked by an IgG4 positive plasma cell infiltrate in tissues. This is central to the disease's pathology. Our review highlights the role of unconventional CD4-positive cytotoxic T lymphocytes, which are now seen as critical drivers of tissue inflammation and fibrosis in IgG4-RD. Additional players include T follicular helper cells, eosinophils, plasmacytoid dendritic cells, ILC2s, and M2 macrophages, forming a complex immune network contributing to disease pathology. Regarding therapeutics, the mainstay treatment for IgG4-RD largely relies on steroids. However, relapses and side effects are common. Our review presents several emerging therapeutics, including inebilizumab, which has gained international attention as the first and only FDA-approved therapeutic for IgG4-RD. Inebilizumab targets an even broader range of B cells, including those problematic long-lived plasmablasts, offering hope for patients resistant to its predecessors. In summary, the intersection between gene variants and novel immune cell involvement is an area of constant discovery, revealing shared disease phenotypes and providing clues about disease etiology. Next generation targeted therapies could soon replace steroids, reducing relapse and providing improved safety in the long term. I trust that our literature review has piqued your interest. Please visit Allergy's website or the Wiley Library, where you will be able to find the open access version of our review. Thank you.